Well, I guess I'm into talking heads now. It's wool, so I had to get it dry cleaned. Like the commercial. Actually, I've liked them since 7th grade. I've never heard a song as chaotic and weird and fun as Once in a Lifetime. The first time I saw the video, however, was when I was a freshman and I was out for a week with the flu. It's funny, a lot of these crushes happen when I'm sick. First, when I was watching Dune while having the stomach bug and liking Sting, and now this. Imagine, you wake up in the middle of the night, open your eyes, they're all still glazed over. And when they finally come into focus, you see this bespectacled, sweaty man screaming,
"This is not my beautiful wife!"
It was pretty unnerving the first time I saw it, but I still really liked the video. But my earliest memory of said sweaty man was when I saw his album in Rolling Stone at the tender age of 8. Mom got the Spice Girls issue to read on the plane, but she ended up not reading it because she fell asleep. And I tried to track down an issue for this video, but no, not at that price. I actually remember looking through it myself and I saw an ad promoting his Feelings album. I was just curious to know what an album with a sad Ken doll on the cover sounded like.
I'm just Dave.
What if he actually sang it though?
I'm just Dave. I wear a big suit and I got a small head. What will it take? Oh, you know what? I can't even do his voice. This is terrible. I'm gonna stop.
So let's fast forward to 2013. Love This Giant, his album with St. Vincent was like my emotional support album.
Someone had fun with the Liquify Tool.
And judging by my look then, yeah, I was definitely a big fan of hers. But alas, there was no crush to be found. It's like he was there, everywhere and nowhere at the same time. Just waiting for the right moment to become my hyperfixation. Something to do on a Friday night. I saw a YouTube video the night before about the re-release of Stop Making Sense, and how, in the author's opinion, this was one of the most neurodivergent concert experiences ever. And I was like, sign me up! As with any movie, I really have a hard time focusing. And I went in not knowing that much of their discography, so at first I was like, when are they gonna play Private Idaho? I think I'm gonna need my Talking Heads fan membership revoked. I went to my local artsy theater and got there a few minutes late. I didn't get to see where David walks in, cues up the Battletoads pause music, and starts playing Psycho Killer. But I caught the end of the song, so I honestly didn't miss that much. It was so good though, and it was also probably the most comfortable and relaxed I felt in a theater in a long time. Nobody got up to dance like in a bunch of the other showings, but I really enjoyed it, and hearing so many good songs played by people who can actually play their instruments was just a delight. Also, when David comes out in the big suit, you just see his shadow for a while, and that's scarier than anything in Five Nights at Freddy's.
For you to truly grasp the allure of David Byrne, I've prepared a presentation.
David Byrne has the jawline that can cut a sandwich and the sleep eyes of an American Girl doll.
Whoa, step aside, Jamie Frazier. Hey, this is the reason you don't have grandchildren. Sorry, Mom.
Can't imagine there's any other reason.
Okay, attention, YouTube. I'm not promoting smoking. See, smoking's bad. Look, he's not even smoking the cigarette. He's just holding it kind of close to his mouth. I'm not promoting
Doofenshmirtz Sable Incorporated.
Oh, he's so cute here. Wait a minute. What's this in the background? Let me just take a look at that for another second. 65 cents a gallon for gas.
Wiki feet.
He's also in a bunch of other movies I haven't seen.
Yep. It's fancy driving, all right.
No, David, that's not how you drive, silly.
Well, let's see if we did something like if we went skinny dipping together.
What?
Hey, Future Rosie here. I'm sick, but I actually got to see True Stories. I thought it was like really cute. John Goodman, of course, is adorable. I just really like the direction of the movie. It was like really quirky. The fashion show part was definitely my favorite. And of course, David Byrne was really cute. I only really get to watch a lot of movies when I'm sick.
I thought I was gonna end the video here, but then I went outside.
Gee whiz, I don't know where the show is.
Oh.
This must be the place.
Oh my god.
Oh, you stink!
Yes, I went to see Start Making Sense, a Talking Heads tribute band that I just found out about that day. I was like impressed from the start. They sounded really good, but like I wasn't dancing in the beginning and I was just kind of standing there watching and listening until they played Life During Wartime. So of course, you see me jumping. It was one of my favorites. I'm gonna skip most of this because it's just like filmed in puco vision and I don't want to make you sick. I was trying to attempt the dance from Stop Making Sense. Once I got to the end, I fell backwards. Okay, let's see that again. But they were so good, like everyone was solid, no one was a slouch, and while I was dancing, I had to like blink my ears twice to realize, oh yeah, I'm listening to a tribute band. The lead singer was fantastic, he had the voice and the moves, and it's just always so cool for me to see another girl bassist. Oh, they sang Genius of Love together too. I love that one. And the backup singers were just killing it. It was so good. I appreciated Talking Heads even more after that because like I realized not only how complex their music is, but it's just so much fun to dance to. I can't imagine how exhausting this show was to play. I tried doing what Tina does and I still haven't gotten the hang of it.
Ugh.
And by attempting to recreate the dance from Once in a Lifetime, when I collapsed on my knees, I bruised myself. Totally worth it though. You know what else was worth it? This t-shirt! I'd say that's all of my review, but like I found some absolutely cursed footage of myself. This is post-fall. I shouldn't be allowed in public.
Are you a shy person?
I'd say so.
How do you...
But that YouTuber was right. It was definitely seeing somebody completely being himself and letting go and unmasking. According to him, he is on the spectrum.
When you have trouble expressing yourself socially in kind of the norm, through the normal channels, conversation, that's one of them, you find other ways to do that. And one way is to get up on a stage, get up on a platform, and just kind of blurt things out.
Me being on the neurospicy side myself, I can relate. And if you don't believe me, I used to get on my desk during class and walk laps around the classroom and like not even realize it. Whether it's Talking Heads or solo stuff, the music definitely scratches that itch in my brain. Like, what I really find interesting about him is that he makes a lot of works and stage shows about his life.
I'm David Byrne.
And I'd like to invite you on an adventure through my imagination.
I feel like I can relate to him so much, where it's difficult to express things in words, but I express it much better in the art that I do, like with my videos and my drawings and comics. I just think it's really cool that he's just totally himself. I don't see self-centeredness in what he does. I see a person expressing themselves and making sense of the world, even if it's their corner of the world. This is a band I got to love for the past few weeks, and I probably will for a while. And I'm glad it was all because of a movie recommendation on YouTube. Thank you, Drywall Studios. You're awesome. I love your channel. And that I made friends through the podcast, so thank you. Anyway, that's all I got. I'm hungry. What kind of snack you want, David?
Peanut butter on a cracker. It's not very fancy, but it happens to be a real favorite.
Good boy. Do you want to eat my prop? No?
We did something like we went skinny dipping together.
Just give me a minute. Oh.
Nausea, heartburn, indigestion, upset stomach, diarrhea.
Yay, Pepto-Bismol!
Now you know.